So let's try to get a little bit of more understanding of the address calculation with pointers. So what is the compiler doing is that it's automatically calculating the byte offsets required based on the type of the pointer whenever we try to do a pointer access. It is using the C semantics for doing this. However, at times we may want to move in the memory location by a different offsets, say for whatever reason, and this is not uncommon in embedded systems. So it is definitely possible inside C. And how we can do it is, we can use explicit typecasting. So we do the same thing again, just that in this case we have another pointer variable star C, and then we again allocate memory to P, end pointer malloc. In this case the size of our index, basically maximum size which has been allocated, is 2 star 4, that is 8 bytes. We allocate the value 3 to star P, that is the first location. And then what we do is, we actually typecast the location pointed to by P to char pointer and assign it to C. So now notice that both C and P are pointing to the same location, just that they are going to access these locations differently. Now here are the series of printfs. First of all, we print the address pointed to by P0, P1 and C1, just to show how the pointer arithmetic is working. Then what we do is, we assign the 0th location a value of 0x1234, that is hexadecimal, and then we have a couple of printfs which are going to print star P, then star C typecasted to a int, okay, and then star C plus 1 again typecasted to a int. So here's a small run. So first of all, the address of P and P1, so P gets some address based on the malloc, and that is 008 in the end. Of course, P1 is going to have an address which is going to be 4 bytes from this, and hence it has a 00C. Notice that C1 only has an address which is plus 1 from the base address of P. The reason being that each character is only 1 byte long, and when we do a C plus 1, the compiler automatically inserts the code to increment it by only 1 byte. Going forward, we have assigned the value of 0x1234 to the 0th location of P, which prints out just fine. However, the C0 and C1 only show the truncated value. So notice that C0 has a value of 0x34 and C1 has a value of 0x12. So I'm sure some of you might have noticed a little bit of an odd thing out here. You might have expected that we had written 0x1234, so I expected the C0 value to be equal to 12 and the C1 value to be equal to 34. So the reason being that this is running on a x86 or an Intel processor, and x86 is what we call as a Little Endian architecture. So in Little Endian architecture, this type of swapping is going to happen just because of the way the words or the integers are represented in hardware. So as part of the exercises, there is a reading link which we ask you to explore and go find out more about the Little Endian and Big Endian architectures. Just to recap, so if we typecast a particular index, or if we access the particular memory using a particular pointer type, then a plus 1 by default is going to just increment it by the data type. So if it is a char pointer, plus 1 means incremented by 1 byte. If it is an integer pointer, plus 1 means incremented by 4 bytes. We have not shown it here, but if I had done a star P in parenthesis plus 1 with a char pointer in front of the 1, it would have actually incremented it by just 1 byte. And there are many other such interesting things which you can try out.